Good afternoon, brothers and sisters. May we invite you to join us in our prayers today. Let us include in our prayers the following intentions: for the needs and intentions of the Greenbelt Chapel community, for all of us here present and the members of our families, and also for those who have asked for our prayers. Let us continue praying for all the victims of war, violence, and natural calamities. Today, the second Sunday of Lent, we pray the sorrowful mysteries. Let us all please kneel as we pray the Holy Rosary. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful and enkindle in them the fire of your love. Send forth your Spirit, and they shall be created. Let us pray. O God, who by the light of the Holy Spirit did instruct the hearts of the faithful, grant that by the same Spirit we may be truly wise and ever rejoice in his consolation. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Thou, O Lord, will open my lips. Incline unto my aid, O God. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Let us now meditate on the five sorrowful mysteries. The first sorrowful mystery is the agony of Jesus in the Garden of Gethsemane. Let us offer this mystery for the needs and intentions of our Holy Father, Pope Francis, for his good health, safety, and protection. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of your mercy. Mother Mary, we beg you, please bring peace to our families, to our country, and to the whole world. Amen. The second sorrowful mystery is the scourging of Jesus at the pillar. Let us offer this mystery for the needs and intentions of the Church and the world, for wisdom and guidance for all church and government leaders, for their good governance and true conversion. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory, Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of your mercy. Mother Mary, we beg you, please bring peace to our families, to our country, and to the whole world. Amen. The third sorrowful mystery is the crowning of Jesus with thorns. Let us offer this mystery for the complete healing and recovery of all who are sick, and for those who care for them, that they may find comfort and protection in their time of need. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of your mercy. Mother Mary, we beg you, please bring peace to our families, to our country, and to the whole world. Amen. The fourth sorrowful mystery is the carrying of the cross by Jesus to Mount Calvary. Let us offer this mystery for all our personal needs and intentions, and the needs and intentions of all the members of our families, relatives, loved ones, and friends, and for all those who have asked for our prayers, especially the intentions offered by the Greenbelt Chapel community.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thine, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thine, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thine, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thine, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thine, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thine, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thine, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thine, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thine, Jesus.
Glory, Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of your mercy. Mother Mary, we beg you, please bring peace to our families, to our country, and to the whole world. Amen. Amen. The fifth sorrowful mystery is the crucifixion and death of Jesus. Let us offer this mystery for all the souls in purgatory, especially the souls of our beloved dead relatives and friends, and those who died with no one to pray for them. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord.
And let perpetual light shine upon them.
May they rest in peace.
Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of your mercy. Mother Mary, we beg you, please bring peace to our families, to our country, and to the whole world. Amen. Together, Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, hail our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To you do we cry, poor banished children of Eve. To you do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Turn then, most gracious Advocate, your eyes of mercy toward us. And after this, our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of your womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray. O God, whose only begotten Son, by his life, death, and resurrection, has purchased for us the rewards of eternal life, grant, we beseech you, that meditating upon these mysteries of the most holy rosary of the Blessed Virgin Mary, we may imitate what they contain and obtain what they promise through the same Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Memorare. Remember, O most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled to thy protection, implored thy help, or sought thine intercession was left unaided. Inspired by this confidence, I fly unto thee, O Virgin of Virgins, my Mother. To thee do I come, before thee I stand, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of the Word Incarnate, despise not my petitions, but in thy mercy, hear and answer me.
Amen.
Prayer to Saint Joseph. O Saint Joseph, foster father of Jesus, most pure spouse of the Virgin Mary, pray for us daily to the same Jesus, the Son of God, that we, being defended by the power of his grace and striving faithfully in life, may be crowned by him at the hour of death.
Amen.
Divine Child Jesus, Antonio de Paz. Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Padre Pio of Pietrelcina.
Pray for us.
All the angels and saints.
Pray for us.
Prayer to Saint Michael the Archangel. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls.
Amen.
Let us all please stand as we now pray the Angelus. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary,
and she conceived the power of the Holy Spirit.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Behold, the handmaid of the Lord.
Be it done to me according to thy word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
And the Word was made flesh
and dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we to whom the incarnation of Christ, your Son, was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection through the same Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was, beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
May the divine assistance remain always with us.
Amen.
And may the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
And may the blessings of the Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, descend upon us and remain with us always.
Amen.
Good afternoon.
Good evening, brothers and sisters.
To preserve the solemnity of our celebration, let us please turn off our cell phones or put them on silent mode. Thank you for your cooperation. We have some announcements. We will be having our Way of the Cross every Friday of Lent after the 6 p.m. Mass, except on March 1. Everyone is invited to join the Tuesday praise and worship after the 6 p.m. Mass. With music, prayer, and thanksgiving, let us celebrate our faith and find hope in the Lord. You are invited to our regular healing Mass every fourth Tuesday of the month during the 6 p.m. Mass. You are invited to the liturgical Bible study of Father Francis Gustilo, SDB, every Wednesday after the 6 p.m. Mass. In partnership with the Assumption College counselors and Sister Amy Hernandez of Verbum Dei Missionaries, Greenbelt Chapel is offering free counseling for individuals, couples, and families. You may schedule an appointment through the chapel office or call 7729-8173. Station of the Cross pamphlets are available at the chapel office at 50 pesos. The book It's All About Relationships by our chaplain Father Dave Concepcion is now available again at the chapel office. As we observe the Lenten season, everyone is invited to join the Live in the Spirit seminar number 44. The registration period is from February 20 to March 12, 2024. This seminar is free. For questions and further information, please visit the Facebook page of the Emmanuel Catholic Charismatic Community. As the Lenten season asks of us to intensify our acts of charity, we will have a second collection after the post-communion prayer. These collections will go to Capuchin Poor Clares of the Blessed Sacrament of Diet for the construction of their main chapel. A Capuchin sister will also be making the appeal later for this endeavor. May our charity help us in our Lenten journey towards a fruitful Easter. For more information, you may visit the Facebook page of the chapel. Welcome to the Holy Sacrifice of the Mass. Today is February 25, 2024, and we are on the second Sunday of Lent. Our presider for this Holy Sacrifice of the Mass is Reverend Father Dave Concepcion. Please stand and let us sing our entrance hymn.
We begin our celebration in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God our Father, and the unity of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
To prepare ourselves to participate in the sacred mysteries, let us first call to mind our sins and humbly ask the Lord for His pardon and mercy. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us of our sins, and bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who have commanded us to listen to your beloved Son, be pleased, we pray, to nourish us inwardly by your word, that with spiritual sight made pure, we may rejoice to behold your glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. God put Abraham to the test. He called to him, "Abraham." "Here I am," he replied. Then God said, "Take your son Isaac, your only one whom you love, and go to the land of Moriah. There you shall offer him up as a holocaust on a height that I will point out to you." When they came to the place of which God had told him, Abraham built an altar there and arranged the wood on it. Then he reached out and took the knife to slaughter his son. But the Lord's messenger called to him from heaven, "Abraham, Abraham." "Here I am," he answered. "Do not lay your hand on the boy," said the messenger. "Do not do the least thing to him. I know now how devoted you are to God, since you did not withhold from me your own beloved son." As Abraham looked about, he spied a ram caught by its horns in the thicket. So he went and took the ram and offered it up as a holocaust in place of his son. Again, the Lord's messenger called to Abraham from heaven and said, "I swear by myself, declares the Lord, that because you acted as you did, in not withholding from me your beloved son, I will bless you abundantly and make your descendants as countless as the stars of the sky and the sands of the seashore. Your descendants shall take possession of the gates of their enemies, and in your descendants all the nations of the earth shall find blessing. All this because you obeyed my commandment." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will walk before the Lord in the land of the living.
I will walk before the Lord in the land of the living.
I believe, even when I said, "I am greatly afflicted," precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his faithful ones.
I will walk before the Lord in the land of the living.
O Lord, I am your servant. I am your servant, the son of your handmaid. You have loosed my bonds. To you will I offer sacrifice of thanksgiving, and I will call upon the name of the Lord.
I will walk before the Lord in the land of the living.
My vows to the Lord I will pay in the presence of all his people, in the courts of the house of the Lord, in your midst, O Jerusalem.
I will walk before the Lord in the land of the living.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, if God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but handed him over for us all, how will he not also give us everything else along with him? Who will bring a charge against God's chosen ones? It is God who acquits us. Who will condemn? Christ Jesus, it is who died, or rather was raised, who also is at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Together, from the shining cloud, the Father's voice is heard. This is my beloved Son. Listen to him.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus took Peter, James, and John and led them up a high mountain apart by themselves. And he was transfigured before them. And his clothes became dazzling white, such as no fuller on earth could bleach them. Then Elijah appeared to them along with Moses, and they were conversing with Jesus. Then Peter said to Jesus in reply, Rabbi, it is good that we are here. Let us make three tents, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah. He hardly knew what to say. They were so terrified. Then a cloud came, casting a shadow over them. From the cloud came a voice, "This is my beloved Son. Listen to him." Suddenly, looking around, they no longer saw anyone but Jesus alone with them. As they were coming down from the mountain, he charged them not to relate what they had seen to anyone, except when the Son of Man had been raised from the dead. So they kept the matter to themselves, questioning what rising from the dead meant. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Perhaps somebody have said this to you. Magsimba ka. Magsimba ka. Ano sagot? Wala naman akong hihingiin.
Kasi maraming nagsisimba dahil mayroong hihingiin. Kung wala kang hihingin, baka meron kang ipagpapasalamat. Kung wala kang hihingin, baka meron kang ipagpapasalamat. Magsimba ka. Magpasalamat ka. Pero sa araw na ito, ang tanong ay, kung wala kang hihingin, wala kang ipagpapasalamat, magsisimba ka pa rin ba? Yun ang tanong. Kung wala kang hihingin, wala kang ipagpapasalamat, magsisimba ka pa rin ba? Mahalaga ho yung tanong na yun. Few days ago, I said a story about an angel with a torch in one hand and a bucket of water in the other hand. And Jesus said to the angel, "What do you plan to do with it?" Ano sabi niya? "With the torch, I will burn heaven, and with the bucket of water, I will cleanse the fire of hell." And Jesus said, "Why?" And the angel said, "So that you will know who really loves you. People follow you, people loves you, they go to church because either they are afraid of hell or they simply want to go to heaven." Ilan sa atin ang gusto lang pumunta sa langit? Ilan na sa atin ang takot lang pumunta sa impyerno? Paano kung walang langit? Paano kung walang impyerno? Magsisimba ka pa rin ba? Yan ang mahalagang tanong sa araw na ito. Saan ba yan sa pagbasa, Father? If you understand clearly the first reading, you know that Abraham had a son at the age of 99. Ngayon, yung anak na yon, hiningi niya talaga yon. At sa gitna ng lahat ng imposibleng pagkakataon, ipinagkaloob sa kanya ng Diyos. Pero, hindi sinabi sa unang pagbasa na merong dalawang anak si Abraham. Dalawang anak ni Abraham. Si Isaac at si Ismael. Si Isaac ang anak ni Sarah. Si Ismael ang anak ni Hagar. Sino si Hagar? Ang katulong. Ang anak na yon, hanggang ngayon, ay mayroong hidwaan. Ang anak na yon, ang mga anak na yon, hanggang ngayon ay may hidwaan. Ang hidwaan ng mga Katoliko at ng mga Muslim. Hanggang kailan? Hanggang magugunaw na siguro ang mundo. Bakit? Parehong nagsasabing, "Ako ang tunay na anak ni Abraham." Mga minamahal na mga kapatid, pero anong meron sa unang pagbasa? Hiningi ng Diyos kay Abraham ang kanyang anak na mahal. At malinaw doon, mas mahal niya si Isaac. Diba? At kung ano yung mahal niya, yun ang kanyang iaalay. Yun ang kanyang iaalay. Kasi madaling ialay yung ayaw mo. Di po ba? Madali. Totoo naman. Pag sinabi mo nga doon sa mga nanay, "Baka pwede po magpare anak nyo." Ang binibigay, pangit. "Father, kunin mo ito kasi wala itong trabaho." Huh? Ano gagawin niya sa simbahan? Pagulong-gulong? Di ba? Pag sinabi mo, "Kunin, Father, baka pwede." Di ba? Ang pinamimigay natin, yung pangit. Totoo naman. Di ba? Kaya pag sinabi mo sa nanay, "Nay, pwede magpare yan." "Father, wag. Sayang." Huh? "Ba't naman sayang?" "Pogiing." Oh. "Pag pogi, ayaw." "Bakit? Pangit ba kami?" Di ba? Mga minamahal na mga kapatid, Bakit yung latak ang ino-offer mo? Magandang itanong yun. Pag kayo namimigay, binibigay, pinipili nyo ba yung the best? Hindi. Huwag kang sinungaling. Di ba? Alam ng Diyos, di ba? No? Sabi, yung mga t-shirt na natanggap mo, bigyan mo yung mga kapatid mo. Pinili mo talaga yung pangit. Yung hindi kasya. Di po ba? No? Di ba? Pag nakatanggap ka ng maraming tuwalya, pipiliin mo talaga yung pag naligo ka, kung ano ang kulay na tuwalya, yun ang kulay mo. Bakit? Pag punas mong ganyan, lahat ng himol-mol ng tuwalya nasa mukha mo. Di ba? No? May mga tuwalyang ganun eh. Di ba? Kaya pag nakatanggap ako ng ganun tuwalya, inaalala ko talaga, sino kaya ang nagbigay nito? Sino? Di ba? Gusto niya ata yun ang kulay mo. Hindi lahat. Ngayon, in-offer yung pinakagusto. Alam natin ang kwento. Dahil ibinigay ni Abraham yung kanyang paborito, pinigilan siya ng Diyos. How we wish stories will be like that always. Diba? Pag sinabing, mas mahal mo yung kabit kaysa sa asawa mo. Di ba mayroong ganun? Di pa ba? Na? Tabi, tabi. Na? Mas mahal yung kabit. Grabe kang tumawa, kuya. Di ba? Pagkamisan, no? Hari nawa, mas maganda yung kaysa sa misis. Di pa ba? Na? Ang malukot na kwento, yung iba kumuha ng kabit, pangit. Mas malaking kasalanan nyo, kumuha ka na ng kabit, pangit pa. Di ba? Oh, sorry ha. Naiskandal yung mga bata. Ano pa? Oh, sabi na ng Diyos, ialay mo na yan. Ialay mo na yan. Di ba? Di kukuha ka ng panaksak. Di ba? Lord, ialay ko na. Lord, ialay ko na. Lord, ialay ko na talaga. Lord! Nag-aantay ka na pigilin, di ba? No? Baka may ipapalit na iba eh. Oh, Lord! Sabi ni Lord, tuloy mo. Oh, malungkot. Di ba? Malungkot. Ano ibig ko sabihin, mga minamahal na mga kapatid? Ang pinagkaiba ni Abraham kay Jesus, si Jesus nag-volunteer. Nakuha po niya? Si Abraham, inutusan. Kaya, si Jesus ay kinalulugdan. Naintindihan po ba ninyo yan? Hindi nyo naintindihan. Ano po? Ganito yan. Pag inutusan mo ang anak mo at sinunod ka, di ba nakakatuwa? Tama po ba? Sino may sabing hindi? Parang ayaw nyo sumagot. Parang... Ha? Inuulit ko, pag inutusan mo ang anak mo at sumunod, masaya ka o hindi? Nakakatuwa ba yung anak? Ha? Parang hindi kayo makasagot. Kaya yung mga anak nyo hindi sumusunod eh. Hindi nyo alam ang sagot eh. Ano ibig ko sabihin? Nakakatuwa ang isang anak na masunurin. Tama po ba? Pero alin ang mas nakakatuwa? Yung hindi mo inutusan pero nagkusa. Why? So naintindihan niya na. Ang pinagkaiba ng unang pagbasa sa Ebanghelyo ay si Abraham inutusan. Sa Ebanghelyo, si Jesus ay nagkusa. Nagkusa. Ngayon, anong meron sa pangalawang pagbasa? Kung ang Diyos ay nagkukusa, naialay ang kanyang sarili, hindi dahil tayo ay karapat-dapat. Palagi ko yung sinasabi, meron pa bang hindi pwedeng ibigay sa iyo ang Diyos? If God has given His only begotten Son, the first reading, dalawang anak. The gospel has only one begotten Son. Kung ang bugtong na anak, ay pinagkaloob ang sarili, hindi dahil tayo ay mabuti, meron pa bang hindi pwedeng ibigay ang Diyos? Meron pa ba? Wala. Ano sabi? There is nothing you can do to make God love you more. And there is nothing you can do to make God love you less. Why? Because God is love by itself. Hindi naapektuhan ang kanyang pagka-Diyos sa ginagawa ng tao. Ay bakit may impyerno, Father? Hindi Diyos ang gumawa doon. Hell is the decision of people who refuse to be with God. It is a decision by people who refuse to be with God. It is not simply committing wrong. Because every time you commit wrong, you despise God. Anong sabi? Bakit ang iyong mga alagad hindi nag-aayuno? Bakit ang alagad ni Juan Bautista at ng mga Pariseo nag-aayuno? Ano sagot ni Jesus? Habang kasama nila ang anak ng kinakasal, sino yon? Si Jesus, hindi sila mag-aayuno. Ibig sabihin, pagkasama mo ang Diyos, hindi ka mag-aayuno. Sa wikang Tagalog, ng pag-aayuno ay nagdadalamhati. Hindi lang yun nagpapalagay ng cross sa noo, hindi lang yun nagpapasting, hindi lang yun nag-almsgiving, hindi lang yung mas mahal, nagdadalamhati. Bakit? Nawala ang Diyos sa kanyang piling. Sa madalit sabi, ang kasalanan ang dahilan kung bakit ang Diyos ay nawawala sa ating piling. Para mas naintindihan ninyo, nakakakita kayo. Bigla kayong nabulag. Wag naman. Pero bigla lang kayo nabulag. Di po ba? Bigla kayo nabulag. Hindi kayo nakakakita. Nawala ba yung mga halaman sa paligid? Hindi. Nawala ba ang simbahan? Hindi. Nawala ba mga kamag-anak mo? Hindi. Ano ang nawala? Nawala ang iyong paningin. Nakukuha po niya? Ang kasalanan ang dahilan kung bakit marami tayong hindi nakikita. Tinakpan natin ang sarili natin mga mata. Kaya tayo nagdadalamhati. Bakit? Ang dating magandang nakikita mo ay wala ka nang makita. Mga minamahal na mga kapatid, ang kwaresma ay hindi lamang tungkol sa kasalanan. Ang kwaresma ay tungkol sa pag-ibig ng Diyos sa gitna ng ating mga kasalanan. Na kung saan ang pinagkaiba ni Abraham at ni Jesus, si Abraham ay inutusan, si Jesus ay nagkusa. Marahil ang tanong sa araw na ito, kailan ka magkukusa? Kung hindi ka uutusan, hindi mo ba gagawin? Ano yung hindi mo ginagawa na alam mong dapat mong gawin? Kasi meron tayong inutusan pero ayaw nating gawin, di ba ba? No? O kaya naman, inutusan, ginawa mo pero ang sama-sama ng kalooban mo. Di ba? Ang tanong ay, ano yung dapat mong gawin na nagkusa ka? Ano yung dapat mong gawin na hanggang ngayon di mo ginagawa? Hindi tayo habang panahon na nasa mundong ito. Hindi tayo habang panahong malakas. Mga minamahal na mga kapatid, kailan kayo matatauhan? Kailan? Pag na-stroke na kayo? Kailan? Di ba? Kailan kayo magkukusa? Yun ang tanong sa araw na ito. Mahirap yung nagbibingi-bingihan tayo, hindi po ba? Ano? Kasi pagdating ng araw, natutuluyan. Yun ang malungkot na kwento. Di ba? My dear friends, my brothers and sisters, you know that Abraham is the father of faith, but Jesus is the beloved son. Listen to him. Amen. Let us now profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The splendor of the Transfiguration counteracts and helps us accept the sad reality of the cross in the life of Christ as well as in ours. Trusting in the unfailing love of the Father, we bring to him our prayers and petitions, and let our response be, Lord, we trust in you.
Lord, we trust in you.
For the Church, may she faithfully accomplish her mission of proclaiming to all nations that Jesus is the only Savior. Let us pray.
Lord, we trust in you.
For the Holy Father, our Bishop, and all other spiritual leaders, may they constantly trust in God's love, even in the midst of afflictions and oppositions. Let us pray.
Lord, we trust in you.
For those who are undergoing severe trials, may they find in the Lord the source of their consolation and strength. Let us pray.
Lord, we trust in you.
For those who feel confused in the midst of so much darkness and uncertainty, may they find meaning for their lives in the teaching and life of Jesus. Let us pray.
Lord, we trust in you.
For all of us, may we live this Lenten season in total availability to do what God wants, in imitation of Abraham and Jesus Christ. Let us pray.
Lord, we trust in you.
Let us pray in silence for our personal intentions.
Ask the Lord, for if God has given his only begotten Son, is there anything God not capable of giving you? Sometimes we fail to receive because we have failed to ask. So ask. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, we trust in you.
God, our loving Father, source of all strength and consolation, make us faithful to you till the end, following the example of Jesus, your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Oh God, I seek you, I seek you. by the mystery. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, to your goodness this wine to offer the fruit of the vine, work and answer, may it become for us spiritual. Lord God, we ask you to receive us. Pray, brothers and sisters, that this sacrifice of yours and mine be made acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
May this sacrifice, O Lord, we pray, cleanse us of our faults and sanctify your faithful in body and mind for the celebration of the Paschal festivities. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For after he had told the disciples of his coming death, on the holy mountain, he manifested to them his glory, to show them, even by the testimony of the law and the prophets, that the passion leads to the glory of the resurrection. And so with all the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end, we acclaim.
Those who cannot kneel, please remain standing and put your right hand on your chest as a sign of reverence.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, gave you thanks, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more gave you thanks, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Bishop, all the bishops and all the clergy. Father, please hear the prayers of your children gathered here before your holy presence. Again, my brothers and sisters, let's spend a few moments of silence. And I invite you that you personally ask the Lord for a special grace you want to receive in this Eucharistic celebration. Ask the Lord. Remember also all our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with Padre Pio, Petrocina, and all the saints who please you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Gathering all our prayers into one, let us now pray to the Father in the very words our Lord Jesus Christ taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all unnecessary worries and distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," kindly look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace within our hearts, peace in our mind, peace in our own homes, in our own families, peace in our workplace, peace here in our community, peace in our country and in the world. And grant unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
My dear brothers and sisters, the peace of our Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us now bless one another by giving each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. My dear brothers and sisters, this is Jesus, the beloved Son of the Father, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are you who are invited here to receive Him in Holy Communion.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. For a solemn reception of communion, we will do it row by row. Please follow the guidance of our ushers. For those outside the chapel, extraordinary ministers of Holy Communion will be at the bridges to distribute Holy Communion. Kindly form two lines before them. Also, please consume the host immediately after receiving them in front of the minister.
Let us pray the prayer of Padre Pio Petrocina.
Please kneel.
Stay with me, Lord, for it is necessary to have you present so that I do not forget you. You know how I easily abandon you. Stay with me, Lord, because I am weak and I need your strength, that I may not fall so often. Stay with me, Lord, for you are my life, and without you I am without fervor. Stay with me, Lord, for you are my light, and without you I am in darkness. Stay with me, Lord, to show me your will. Stay with me, Lord, so that I hear your voice and follow you. Stay with me, Lord, for I desire to love you very much and always be in your company. Stay with me, Lord, if you wish me to be faithful to you. Stay with me, Lord, for as poor as my soul is, I want it to be a place of consolation for you, a nest of love. Stay with me, Jesus, for it is getting late, and the day is coming to a close, and life passes, death, judgment, eternity approaches. It is necessary to renew my strength so that I will not stop along the way, and for that I need you. It is getting late, and death approaches. I fear the darkness, the temptation, the dryness, the cross, the sorrows. Oh, how I need you, my Jesus, in this night of exile. Stay with me tonight, Jesus, in life with all its dangers, I need you. Let me recognize you as your disciples did.
So that the Eucharistic communion be
the light
which
disperses the darkness, the force which sustained me, the unique joy of my heart. Stay with me, Lord, because at the hour of my death, I want to remain united to you, if not by communion, at least by grace and love. Stay with me, Jesus. I do not ask for divine consolation because I do not merit it, but the gift of your presence, oh yes, I ask this of you. Stay with me, Lord, for it is you alone I look for. Your love, your grace, your will, your heart, your spirit, because I love you and ask no other reward but to love you more and more. With a firm love, I will love you with all my heart while on earth and continue to love you perfectly during all eternity.
Amen.
Please rise. Let us pray.
As we receive these glorious mysteries, we make thanksgiving to you, O Lord, for allowing us while still on earth to be partakers even now of the things of heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Kindly be seated for a moment for the second collection.
May we call on Sister Angel to make appeal for the from Capuchin Poor Clares of the Blessed Sacrament.
A blessed evening po sa inyong lahat. Muli po ako, Sister Angel, and with me also is Sister Rowena. We are contemplative nuns, mga monghas po kami, and we belong to the Second Order of the Franciscan Family. Our mission is perpetual adoration of the Blessed Sacrament. Ngayon po, our community is newly established in the Diocese of Daet Camarines Norte. And because we're just starting, a temporary house has been given to us to use while waiting for our monastery to be built. With God's grace, with the support of good-hearted people, yung first phase and second phase na po ng aming monasteryo ay tapos na. And now we would like to concentrate on the third phase, which is the monastery chapel. That's the reason why po we have this mission appeal right now. And may we take this opportunity to knock on the doors of your heart for financial support for the building of our monastery chapel in the Diocese of Daet Camarines Norte. Napakahalaga po sa amin ang chapel. As nuns dedicated to prayer, ito po yung heart ng aming monastic community. And it will not redound only to the benefit of the community, but also to the benefit of the local church in the place, in the Diocese of Daet. Kaya po, yung tulong po na maibibigay po ninyo ay napakalaking bagay na po sa amin. It will make a big difference in our monastic life, in our community, and in the local church of the Diocese of Daet, because that said chapel will be dedicated to our Lord. And so may we appeal again to you, and we would like to thank you in advance for the support that you're going to give to us. May God bless you all po, us po. And if you happen to have intentions after the Mass, pwede rin po kayong lumapit sa amin para rin po maisama namin kayo sa aming may intentions. Salamat po.
Mm-hmm.
Please rise. Maraming salamat po. Ano po? Maraming. Suklian nawa ang inyong kabutihan. Going back to what I've said, nakakatuwa kung ang anak ay masunurin. Pero mas nakakatuwa kung nagkukusa. Hindi po ba, ano? Nakakatuwa yung nangutang, pag siningil mo, nagbayad. Di ba totoo? Pero mas nakakatuwa yung kahit hindi mo sinisingil, nagkusa. Di ba? Nakakatuwa yung mga anak na pag sila'y sumahod na at hiningan mo, anak, baka naman pwedeng ikaw na magbayad ng kuryente. Opo, nakakatuwa yun, no? Pero mas nakakatuwa pag yung anak nagkukusa kahit hindi hiningan. Di ba? Yung, ma, ako na lang. Tama na, Father. Tama na. Alam mo na ako saan papunta yan. Di po ba, no? My dear friends, my brothers and sisters, God has taken delight on the obedience of Abraham, but he behold his only begotten son, for his son has taken the initiative. Sana mayroong pagkukusa. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Bless your faithful, we pray, O Lord, with a blessing that endures forever, and keep them faithful to the gospel of your only begotten Son, so that they may always desire and at last attain the glory whose beauty he showed in his own body, to the amazement of his apostles, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you and your family, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We now go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Thank you, sisters and brothers, for coming to celebrate the Mass with us.